there was trouble.
Help! Help! My brakes have failed! Help! Look out, Emily! I can't stop! I have to slow her down!
Stop! Stop! Cried Toby. His driver fought for control. They came nearer and nearer to the bridge. The driver braked hard. Toby stopped, still on the rails, but with his wheels treading the tightrope over the abyss. Mavis was horrified and quickly came to the rescue. Workmen anchored Toby with chains while she pulled the trucks away. Then she helped Toby to safety.
Scarlowy was nearing the wharf again. Then there was trouble. Logs broke free at the forest mill. They rumbled and tumbled down the hill. And Reneus was coming the other way.
Oh no, cried Scarlowy. The logs will hit Reneus.
Scarlowy tried peeping and calling, but Reneus didn't hear. So Scarlowy steamed forward as fast as he could. The log hit Scarlowy with a great big boof. Scarlowy was dented and the bull roared, but luckily no one was hurt. Reneus was very happy to be saved.
Excuse me, said Rusty. Do you like bluebells?
The engine looked startled.
Yes, bluebells are beautiful.
Then you're soon going to see lots of them because I'm getting you out of here.
Everyone worked fast.
It was difficult to set the fire, but soon it was glowing hot and Stepney had a good head of steam. Rusty's engineer agreed to be Stepney's fireman. So off they set, past the bleak and brooding line of diesels.
Where is he going?
They hissed.
Just down the line, replied Rusty.
And they chuffered quickly away.
We've done it. We're over the border and back on our own railway. Mission accomplished.
Thomas puffed towards the bridge, unaware of the danger ahead.
Thomas! Jack jumped in and lifted his front loader up against the bridge. He pushed with all his might. Thomas saw the flagman. His driver applied the brakes, but it was too late.
Cinders and ashes, cried Thomas.
Jack didn't let go.
Finally, Thomas's driver backed Thomas to safety.
Hold on, Jack,
called Kelly, and he rushed to help. Jack couldn't hold the bridge any longer.
Are you all right, Jack? I think so.
I want to get out. I want to get out, he sighed. One moment, everything seemed safe, then suddenly... Falcon was derailed and hung dangerously over the edge. Duke bravely held on with all his strength. "Stop shaking," he called. "I can't hold you if you shake." Duke's driver and fireman worked quickly to make the two engines safe again. Then came more trouble. "Water!" cried Duke's fireman. "Duke needs water, quickly!" Luckily, there was a workman's cottage nearby. Soon everyone was passing jugs, buckets, kettles and saucepans filled with water until Duke's thirst was quenched. All the while, Duke was building more strength. At last, with everyone's help, he was able to pull Falcon back onto the rails.
Of my way, you silly little engine. You're too slow to be really useful. Oh, Stephen, you saved me and my passengers.
No, James, go forward. It's a landslide.
Percy, you have to get out of there.
James needs my help. I must be brave.
Percy!
Escaping? From what? Scrap? Douglas shivered. Then he remembered Edward's story about saving Trevor.
"I'll be glad to help you," he said. "It'll have to look as if you're ready for scrap, and I'm taking you away."
The drivers and firemen agreed to help too. Everyone worked fast.
"No time to turn around," panted Douglas. "I'll run tender first. Come on."
But before they could clear the station, they were stopped.
"Aha!" exclaimed a foreman. "A Great Western engine and a brake van too. You can't take these."
"Ach, but they're all for us," said Douglas's driver. "See for yourself."
The foreman looked all over Oliver.
"Seems in order. Right, away, guard."
"I can't stop. Help, help. We're coming," called Edward. Thank you.
Edward was panting up behind with every ounce of steam he had. At last he caught up with James.
Steady, Edward, called his driver. The inspector stood on Edward's front, holding a noose of rope in the crook of the shunter's pole. He was trying to slip it over James's buffer. The engine swayed and lurched. At last! Got him! He shouted. He pulled the noose tight. Gently braking, Edward's driver checked the engine's speed, and James's fireman scrambled across and took control.